guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. This mirror is always obstacling, always objecting me, interrupting me. I don't know. What do you call it? It's always an... It's okay. Anyway, so today we are here to start. Today we are going to try out this palette. This is not a new palette, but it's a new palette for me, and I'm really excited to try it and buy it actually since so long, and I've always kept postponing it. But finally, I have it with me, and I'm very excited to try this one. And this is the B Carnival XL Pro palette by Stacy Marie in collaboration with Stacy Marie by Be Perfect. Okay, so it's a very beautiful palette. I've seen a lot of people use this and create really, really beautiful looks. And I also really wanted to do one. So I was going to try this palette out. I thought then, you know, let's just film like a first impression. Like, you know, if you also want to know what I think about this palette, I feel like I will definitely love it. Because there's I've actually asked Palak, if you guys know, she does like beautiful makeup, and she said like, you know, it is really good, do get it. So I'm sure I'm gonna like it, but I still want to test and try if it click up to my taste or not, because everybody has different tastes and everything. Look at how beautiful this palette is. I mean, it's like gigantic, literally. Look, it's bigger than my face. It has so many different colors, it has highlighters, etc. I got this on my own. I bought this from a page, Makeup and You, I believe, or something. I'll just put it in the description. I don't remember from whom I bought this. It was around some 5,200 or something. And yeah, anyways, let's get started. So I was just doing my base, then I realized I need to, you know, try a new palette, and I don't know how it performs, and the look I have in mind is very colorful, so I just stopped. I just have foundation on, and then my lips, like everything was looking very pale, so I added a little bit of lipstick. So there's this eyeshadow look I saw on Instagram, and I really want to recreate it, and I think this is the perfect palette for that, because it has so many different colors, and that has like almost 4 to 5 different colors, so this would be like a perfect palette for that one. So we are going to use this one today, and I'm just going to do a little bit of brow and eye prep using the e.l.f. Instant Lift Brow Pencil. So for the first shade, I'm going to go in with this shade. This is called Haul. I've not used this palette on my eyes even once. This is literally the first time, so I cannot wait to see how it, you know, looks. Very excited about that. I mean, I did not expect any less pigment from this palette, but it surprises me every time. Next, I'm going in with this shade called Slow Burn, and I'm going to blend those edges out further and diffuse them and make it a little, like, you know, smoky. That is kind of blending out well, and I am like diffusing the edges a little more, like basically adding more depth, because I'm going to cut the crease. And because I didn't do my base concealer, etc., I can literally go till here also, and then I can wipe it off. Usually I always do base first instead of eyes, but you know, there are a lot of advantages to do eyes first. You can do whatever you want. Even if you mess up, you don't have to ruin your entire base. You just wipe off the eyes and start over, and then you know, then you can do your base. But I don't know, I'm just habituated to doing it the other way around. Now I'm just going to wipe off that excess product on the lid before cutting my lid, because I don't want like so many piles of concealer on my eyelid. I usually just go in with it, but today I have the patience to kind of rub and do it. Taking the concealer, it's like I'm dictating. Now I'm just going to take a spoon and eat it, like I don't know it. My brain is just like all over the place. But anyways, I'm just cutting my crease, and I don't like this brush. don't know why the concealer is so uneven. Next, the idea is I go from yellow to purple. So the first color I'm going to add in the starting is this shade. This is the shade called Keen, and I'm just going to take that on a flat brush, and I'm going to that is 1 minute. Let me just like pack it on and see how it goes on. Yeah, that is one of the best yellows I have tried. All the yellows I use, I think this is the really nice one. I like this way better than the James Charles palette's yellow. James Charles palette yellow does not look good. I mean, it does not go on that easy. You'll have to build it up so much, and it kind of is a little patchy. Basically, when you want to pack it up, when you want to kind of blend it, you can work with it. But if you want to like have that color there, then it's coffee difficult. So next I'm going to go with this shade Lit, and I'm going to pack that right beside the yellow. And next I'm going in with the shade Inferno. I'm going to apply that beside that orange. So basically yellow, red and orange. Then I'm going to go in with this shade called Wasted. This is like a beautiful purple. I'm going to add that right beside the... That's a very, very good purple. First, just going to pack this color on, and in the end we'll do all the blending part. Then next I'm going in finally with this blue. This is the shade Make Waves. This blue. Make Waves, and I'm going to add that in the outer edge and make a wing out of it. I'm going to take a clean brush and just blend these edges between all the colors. That Loki looks like that parrot you have. Is it Kingfisher? The Kingfisher logo parrot. And the normal, you know, there's a parrot which looks like exactly like this. So when I saw that picture and I, you know, took that inspiration from that, I didn't think, like, it did not look like parrot on her, but on me it does. So I don't know what to do about that, but it looks nice. At the end of the day, it looks nice, and I don't mind it. So next she added glitter on the top part, so I'm going to just finish this eye and be back for that. So let's move on to the glitter part, and I only have this one glitter liner, and this is the Urban Decay Heavy Metals in the shade, there's no shade, it's basically like a silver glitter liner. So I'm just going to apply that and see how it looks. If it doesn't look, then I just use like a loose glitter which kind of balances out. That is good, right? I should not move until it dries. I think it looks good. I probably will add like a pink one. I have this one from Forever 52, so probably I'll just like add in between and something like that, so that it looks more you know, cohesive. I'm sorry if I'm not like entertaining you as much in this video. It's just been a very weird day. I woke up in a such a terrible, like, you know, mood. Then I was just like, I worked out and then it, like, it was downhill. My mood, everything was kind of very bad. So I'm trying to put myself together and do this video. I don't know, bro, this look is turning out more and more bad as I go, and the camera doesn't want to focus on me. There's obviously glitter glue, but I don't know where it is, and I don't think I have it right now. So I'm just going in with the lash glue and hoping this glitter will stick to that. I think I kind of ruined it. The white one was only looking a lot better. So I'm just trying to go over it and fix it. The pink is very dominant, so I have to kind of balance it out on the other side. I'm just going to quickly do the rest of my base before I go in with my lower lash line and lashes, liner, etc. Now Now for the lower lash line, I'm going to go in back with the color I put on my crease. So I'm going to use the shade Haul and Slow Burn, and I'm going to just pack that on my lower lash line. Forgot to apply my nose highlight, and I always look very incomplete without that. So I'm just going to add that in the... You can see, you can immediately see the difference when I apply nose highlight and I don't. See, it does make a difference, right? Like the tiny bit of highlighter also is like a lot. Now, next I'm just going to use liner. Let me actually check if she is wearing liner. So I'll just show you the reference pick I'm using. This is the reference pick. This is the reference pick. This is Beat by Deb. It looks gorgeous on her. Like mine didn't turn out as good as her, but she did not actually apply liner. But I'm just going to very like thin line so that the lash band actually fits well. Yeah, now just pop on some lashes, a little bit of mascara, and I'll be back with my final look. So yeah guys, that's it for the finished look. The palette is really good. Like I told you, I knew I was going to like it, but I just wanted to try it on camera for the first time and do a look for you guys so that you can see it. So I don't even know if I'm going to upload this video, but if I did and you're watching this, then if it's not up to the mark, then I'm sorry, like, you know, we'll do better in the next video. But I hope you like the eye look. I tried and did something, and I hope, like, I really like it. I hope you like it too. And that's it for this video. Make sure you like and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell, because usually it is not this boring. Sometimes we do have fun, but this one was a little off. I can feel it, so I really don't know if I'm gonna put it or not. Like, I'll decide it while I'm editing. If you're watching, then it's obviously I did upload it. Okay, I'm talking too much, but anyways, this is a very beautiful palette to invest in. My makeup wipe got stuck in that, lol. So it's a very beautiful palette to invest in. It even has like highlighters on one side, and it has more like, you know, a beautiful neutral then colors, etc. You can do literally infinite number of looks with this, and these are really good highlighter. I just put that highlighter on my skin as well, and it looks really nice. Maybe I'll just put a little bit on my skin and I'll show. See, I'm just taking the shade Fair Play, and I'm just going to add that. I don't want it to become too much, so just add a little bit. It's really beautiful. So especially if you're a beginner who's getting into makeup and wants one palette which has a lot of different shades, then you can definitely go for this one. It is a very beautiful palette. Is definitely, it's an investment, because 5,000 is not cheap in India, but if you do get it, you would not regret it. Anyways, that's it for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.